Let's go to my vigilant producer, Alex Logan, in the command center. Alex, what do you got on the war on drugs?
All right, well, let's start with the first Democratic presidential debate, where the candidates were asked about the upcoming Nevada marijuana legalization initiative being voted on next November.
You said you smoked marijuana twice, didn't quite work for you. If you were a Nevada resident, how would you vote?
I suspect I would vote yes. And I would vote yes because I am seeing in this country too many lives being destroyed for nonviolent offenses.
While Hillary Clinton would vote against the initiative, stating,
I do support the use of medical marijuana, and I think even there, we need to do a lot more research so that we know exactly how we're going to help people for whom medical marijuana provides relief.
Where do you stand on the governor? Is it time to legalize it?
Absolutely, and that's Hillary Clinton doing the best two-step dance routine I've ever heard. That's the old standard answer. We need to study it more. They've been studying it now for decades. No more study needs to go out on it. We know that medical marijuana works for seizures and epilepsy. We know medical marijuana works for cancer. They're now even finding out it causes tumors to disappear, all sorts of stuff like that. It's endless. What else is marijuana good for? Clothing. You can make clothes out of marijuana. Rope. And do you know what else? Biodiesel fuel. Marijuana can make us independent of energy from foreign countries if we were to decriminalize it, grow it, and use it to the full extent of the plant. You know, Willie Nelson does more than smoke it. He drives it in all his tour buses. He walks the walk and talks the talk when it comes to marijuana. It is ridiculous, and for Hillary Clinton to take that two-step, well, I think we need to study it some more. We've been studying it for 50 years, Hillary. The jury's back. Medical marijuana is good, and recreational marijuana is good also. By the way, for Hillary and all them out there, while they're having their martinis, 88,000 people last year died from the use of alcohol in some way, shape, or form.
Well, we did the research for the former Secretary of State ourselves, and we ran the numbers. Here's what we found in this edition of the Money Trail. The war on drugs continues to wage on, and America's left with the bill. According to drugpolicy.org, the U.S. spends more than $51 billion annually to fight the war on drugs. There are about 346,605 people serving sentences in state and federal prison for drug possession or sales in the United States. And on average, it costs $25,251 to incarcerate a federal prisoner for 1 year. That's nearly $9 billion wasted per year on incarcerating a mental health issue.
Exactly, and I saw the first results. I have friends that live close to me down off the grid in Mexico, and they happen to be from the state of Washington, who is legalized now, marijuana. The first result, they saw their state judicial budget drop 15%. That's mammoth. A 15% drop in their state's judicial budget simply because they're not prosecuting marijuana anymore.
And so not only are we wasting money, but we're also wasting time and resources. A research study found that during the span of 11 years, the NYPD alone made a total of 439,056 possession-only arrests. Multiplied by 2.5 hours of police time per arrest, that equals just over 1 million hours of police officer time to make 440,000 marijuana arrests. That is the equivalent of having 31 police officers working 8 hours a day, 365 days a year, for 11 years, making only marijuana possession arrests.
That's absurd. You know, Republicans talk about us paying too much in taxes. How come they don't use this as an example? And for all of you religious people out there, right? Didn't God make it? If you believe God created everything on this planet and he created it for us to use, then God made marijuana. At what point will we bust God? Shouldn't God do his time for making it?
Whether we put God behind bars or not, Jesse, I mean, how do we let this quote-unquote war continue when it's clearly bleeding this country dry?
Well, you need to elect the right people. You need to elect people in government who truly want to reduce government, who truly want you to pay less taxes for common sense things. The war on drugs is happening because clearly Democrats and Republicans are getting paid off to keep this war going. Somebody's making money. Always follow the money. So somebody in high places is making money off the war on drugs.
Well, let's talk about how much we could stand to make off of this if we were to legalize and tax them. I mean, this is the most frustrating part about all of it. If California alone legalized only marijuana, they would see a tax revenue increase of $1.4 billion. If we were able to tax it at a comparable level to alcohol and tobacco, nationwide tax revenue would equal $46.7 billion.
So we're kicking away $46 billion spending $51 billion, right? So that's nearly $100 billion of waste every year in the United States of America on the war on drugs.
And you take into account all the, you know, putting prisoners, prison time, cops on I mean, the money's endless. It's billions upon billions. What else can be done to prove that legalizing drugs will benefit almost everyone, even the government?
Obviously, and I'll repeat this again, somebody in a powerful place in our government's making money off keeping it illegal. They have to be. They have to be making money. That's why they continue to do it. That's it for today's Off the Grid. Be sure to check out aura.tv/off the grid for exclusive videos and articles by my Off the Grid contributors and me. Until next time, stay vigilant, people.